Then the secondary task force would move in. Their job would be to deal with the machinery and to use the pumps to refill the plash with water from the river. Willie's tertiary group could then join them, and they would all stage a peaceful sit-down protest and refuse to move until the plash was returned to its former glory and alternative plans for the preservation of Harpax Grange were explored. And so Oberon and his guerrillas had set off for Harpax in their cars, while a disappointed Willie had followed along in a camper van that Onions had borrowed from his parents. Also in the van, and making up the remainder of the tertiary task force, were those protesters most likely to be unpredictable. Regular Flan member Terry and a barrel-bellied biker from Pawley known as Revin Kevin, who was decorated head to toe in bad tattoos. Both men had taken the news of their assignments as badly as Willie, and the van was full of simmering resentment.
"Why am I dressed as a lion?" asked Caudry.
He presented a strange sight, dressed only in a bathrobe borrowed from the New Empire Hotel and wearing an oversized animal costume head. Keeley looked equally bizarre as a sphere-headed panda. They were standing in the dark of a wooded glade, the only light being cast by Pamela Dalimore's torch.
"The fancy dress shop didn't have any wolves left," she explained. "There's been a run on animal costumes, apparently. The important thing is that no one will be able to tell that it's you."
"Why are we doing this again?" asked Caudry.
Mrs. Dalimore took a deep breath and wondered whether her decision to use the haggard-looking couple had been the right one. At first they'd seemed perfect, nondescript, naturally pale, and a little bit pudgy, full of bravado and willing to take a risk for the thrill of public sex.